Hi, I'm Chris Cordy of American Trade School. I'm the Program Director of the Heating and Air Conditioning Division. I'm here today with TurboTorch, and we're going to be discussing some of the best practices for HVAC technicians. One of those best practices is nitrogen purge. When you're brazing the copper lines together, the chemical reaction between the oxygen, the heat, and the copper produces a carbon. All the black stuff that you see on the outside of the copper pipe is also on the inside if you do not remove the oxygen. Therefore, the importance of purging that line with nitrogen to remove the oxygen prevents the carbonization inside the line. There's been several incidences where the carbon will clog up the meter device itself. The tiny flakes that are going through the orifice inside the refrigeration system get clogged up in the meter device and makes it fail. And therefore, that's just one example of the contaminant inside the refrigeration system, such as carbon. So on the nitrogen bottle itself, we will hook up the regulator. Once we assemble the nitrogen regulator onto the nitrogen tank, once you open the tank, soap bubble that to make sure that we're not going to lose nitrogen out of it. The flow regulator, once we do the blast of nitrogen through your line set to remove any contaminants and oxygen, the flow regulator will be hooked up, and that's got a Teflon seal on it, which seals up very nice and tight. Our kit does come with a short hose to actually be able to hook up onto the system directly through the Schrader core, and it does have a Schrader core depressor if you do have your Schrader cores that are in. If not, we can hook this up directly onto the cone tip into an open line to allow flow of nitrogen. You'll hear a lot of excuses why you should not purge or you don't need to purge, but in reality, the carbon buildup that gets into the oil, refrigerant oil, and that can actually clog up the liquid line filter dryer in the meter device carries a lot more weight as far as validation why you need to do it compared to why you shouldn't do it. So the first thing we do after we connect our joints together, we want to remove the Schrader cores before we are going to braze or do the nitrogen purge. We want to remove both Schrader cores, one out of the liquid line and one out of the suction line. Next, we'll go ahead and set up our nitrogen. We'll open our tank, make sure we stand off to the side, adjust our regulator into approximately 40 psi, never over 50. Connect our hose to the liquid line. This will allow the nitrogen to actually flow into the liquid line, through the meter device, through the evaporator, back to the suction, and it will release the pressure here so we don't pressurize the system while we're brazing. Adjust our flow. And it takes just a little bit of balance to adjust your flow rate. But you want to adjust your flow rate to about 4 to 5 cubic feet per hour. That'll allow that nitrogen to release. And right now what's going on is we're actually pushing all the oxygen out of the line set that's already been connected. And now we're going to chase the nitrogen with our torch. We'll braze our first joint here on our liquid line, go inside, braze the joint on the liquid line, braze the suction line on the inside, and come back out and finish up on the joint on the suction, chasing the nitrogen.